Hanuma Vihari, the New Age Buddha. He meditates with a cricket bat and can do so for hours. Hailing from Kakinada in Andhra Pradesh, the right-hander knew he had to be meticulous to earn an India cap. With a test debut in England, followed by series wins in Australia and West Indies, and many a solid performance in the Indian domestic scene, Vihari has shown that he is certainly here to stay and is our guest on episode 2 of Tissot Presents Sportstar Extras T20 Time.
Hi guys, welcome to Sportstar Extras T20 Time presented by Tissot, and we are very glad and fortunate to have Hanuma Vihari with us today. Thank you, Hanuma, for joining us.
Pleasure.
India test player, has been playing the IPL for a long time. He's not a part of the IPL this season, but then he's seen IPL from very close quarters, and also won the Under-19 World Cup for India in 2012. So, lots of stories, Hanuma. So, just to start with, this has been a very difficult phase, I mean, for all of us, and also particularly for the cricketers. So, how have you been spending your time in this lockdown?
First 4-5 months, it was tough, you know. I couldn't even go out of the house and play cricket, but now I've started practice. I'm preparing for the Australian tour coming up. So, I've kept myself busy now in the last couple of months. And IPL has started as well, so you've got something to watch on TV. So it has been tough initially, but we got used to it. You know, that's the new normal now, as they say. So I got used to life at this point.
How do you maintain your composure? You know, because you have been in tough situations. You have been to Australia. I mean, we all know how tough it is to be in Australia with so much of chit chat going around. But you have always maintained that composure. How you do that? What's your thought process? You know, when you go out to bat.
I just try to keep things simple. You know, before going into bat, I try to assess the situation. Now I'm batting number 6 for India, which I've not done in my life, throughout my life. You know, I've always batted at the top of the order. But it's a new challenge, so I try to read the situation and understand what I need to do in that kind of situation, and go out there and try to execute what I'm trying, what I planned before going into bat. So I know, you know, even I feel a lot of pressure inside, but I try not to show it in my body language or with the expressions or whatever it is. I try to keep myself calm, and I try to get myself in, and that's the whole execution part comes into play then. But usually my, as you said, I try to keep myself calm and keep that composure going.
You are preparing for another Australia tour, which is coming up later this year. But then that was like very new in your career. I mean, you had just made your debut in England, and just a few months down the line, you went to Australia, and there was a lot of chit-chat going around with Rishabh Pant, Jim Payne and everything. How was your, you know, experience, you know, being in the middle? And I remember you opened the batting also in one of the test matches. Yeah. So how was that experience? How did you deal with it? And if you could tell us about what usually happens in Australia, how nasty were the bowlers?
I think when we played Australia last time, they were the nicer guys. Like, you know, they after all the incidents that has happened in South Africa to them, you know. I wouldn't say they were like us, but they were fine. You know, they were not too many. They were odd incident, like you said, Rishabh and Payne had a healthy banter between each other, and I would call it healthy because, you know, they had it was nothing out of the line. But you find that in Australia, especially the crowd is quite intimidating, which I don't think we'll have it this time. But it's always fun playing against Australia, especially in Australia.
Hanuma Vihari means a lot of patience, determination. You leave the balls, you tire out the bowlers. So what is that temperament going into a series that is overseas conditions? How do you prepare? You know, for example, you went to West Indies also, you went to England also, and every country has different conditions. So how does your mind work around those conditions?
For me, especially for my game, I feel preparation is the key. If I prepare well, then I stay confident, and I put a lot of hard work in preparation. After, if I know that I prepared well, then I don't take the results too seriously. I'll have a game plan. I'll try and assess the condition. I'll try and read what the bowlers are trying to do. But after that, I don't really take results too seriously, and try and focus on what I need to do in that situation. Because for a batsman like me, I need to hit a lot of balls in practice, which I try to do maybe 1 month or 2 months before a series if I get time. Now I have enough time to prepare for the Australian series, which I'm doing right now. And if I know I'm confident going into a series, then I'll be in good, I'll be in good stead going into that series. Now I feel I'm confident, although I've not played a match in maybe 6-7 months. Last match which we played in February, that was against New Zealand. But
yes,
I'm still confident. I know if I can get into the groove, then I can perform for the team.
You are a very serious character. It takes a lot of time to make you laugh at a joke, actually. So, but then IPL, there's a lot of, like a lot of banter, a lot of fun things going around. And do you remember your first IPL game? And who were you batting with? And what are the memories from, you know, the first IPL match when you walked in to play for Sunrisers Hyderabad?
Actually, I was quite surprised that I played the first game of the tournament. You know, usually a youngster walks in, 18-year-old, they don't really get an opportunity unless a team is losing or the players are not performing. But they had the trust in me, the coach Tom Moody and captain Kumar Sangakkara at that point of time. They had the trust, and I went in like when we were 3 down or 4 down, we were like batting in the 17th over. So I only got 12 or 13, but my second match was quite memorable. I got the wicket of Chris Gayle, and obviously I was man of the match after that in that game. So it was quite a memorable tournament for me, the first one in the IPL, and I thought I learned a lot from that tournament.
What was the exchange with Kumar Sangakkara before the game? Because I think that was in 2013, and it was right after your Under-19 World Cup. I think one season after your Under-19 World Cup. So there were like a lot of stars in Sunrisers Hyderabad team. Tom Moody being a big star for Australia, and then you have Kumar Sangakkara. So do you remember what were the conversations like? And because you were fairly new, how did they treat that youngster back then? And how much confidence did you get by playing in that IPL?
I was really quiet at that time as well. You know, I never used to talk much. But whatever I've spoken,
even lesser than now.
Yeah.
Definitely. Oh my
God. Yeah. So whatever conversation I had with Kumar was obviously being a great cricket. Especially I liked even then I liked Test cricket a lot. So I always used to ask him. You know, he got a lot of double hundreds for Sri Lanka. So I used to ask him what was his preparation like before a Test match. And he always used to said, you know, even he was like me, he likes to eat a lot of balls. Even between the test match, he said that he eats a lot of balls to get that confidence going before the match. So that was the kind of conversation I had. It was more about test cricket. And even coming to T20 cricket, he kept things very simple, like which I like to do, played orthodox shots, not too inventive or something like that. And we had many other great cricketers in that team. You know, Dale Steyn was there, and there were many others as well. So I had a great experience in that tournament.
Any funny incidents that you remember from that year or maybe the year after? I think you played for 2-3 seasons after that too. So,
yeah.
And IPL provides you that chance to, you know, rub shoulders with all the international stars. Like, for example, you said that you picked the wicket of Chris Gayle. It's a big thing for a youngster. So,
yeah.
Do you have any funny incidents, any fun moments with the teammates that you remember?
I don't get too involved in those mischievous things, but overall, the tournament was fun. You know, I would say we had a great bunch of guys, and even in the dressing room, they would always crack a joke. They are players from different environments, so you expect that. And to team to bond, you need different kind of characters, I would say. And there were different kind of characters in the Hyderabad team at that point of time. And I really enjoyed listening to them rather than getting in conversation with them.
But IPL meant a lot of parties also. So what did you do when those parties used to happen? Were you like confined to your hotel room and still watching cricket or thinking about the game?
When we had a team get together, I was always there. You know, if it was a compulsory thing. But even if we won a game, then obviously the team would sit together and celebrate the victory. But otherwise, I was always in the room. I was always preparing for the next game, and like I always do.
Talking about friendships in cricket, and there are so many we see, and IPL provides that chance too again, and also in international cricket. So overall, who has been, you know, you can tell me 2-3 names, your closest confidants on the cricket field with whom you can share everything, anything, maybe on and off the field both.
My closest one in cricket would be, you know, my coach from childhood. We had a same journey. He was part of the academy when I was 11 years old. Yeah, John sir, then Sridhar sir as well. Sridhar sir is I had continued with the Indian team as well. So I was quite fortunate that when I got into the Indian side, he was part of it. So I could share a lot of my feelings and how I felt about the game, or or what I was going through in between the game. So he was someone I was looking up to. So I'm really close to him, you know, when it comes to talking cricket and sharing my feelings of what I feel about the game. So he's one person, I would say.
Also, I've seen videos of John Sir talking really proudly about you and when you walked into his academy as a kid and everything. So it's like a really a very memorable story to follow. Moving on to a very important person in the Indian cricket team, our captain, Virat, who is totally opposite to you. So how do you guys get along and, what do you guys talk when you are on the field as well as off the field? I really want to know that how two contrasting personalities come together to play for India. And so tell us a little bit about your memories with Virat.
I have a lot of good memories with him, you know, especially in the recent past. Recently, I would say in the New Zealand series, he's not got much runs in the New Zealand series. So he was, I would say, not as aggressive as he usually is on the field. Actually, New Zealand, you see them and you feel that, you know, they're nice guys. They don't talk much like Australians. But actually, they were kind of sledging me at that point of time. So,
So
I thought, you know, if I can go and communicate with Virat, then I can, you know, he'll be charged up a little bit more than what he was doing in that series, I thought. And I went up to him and told him, see, they're talking like this to me and I think we have to give it back to them. And on the field, I'm quite calm off the field, but on the field, I try to be aggressive as well. I don't show it in my body language, but in my mind, I try to be aggressive. And he was really charged up after that. And I try to, you know, whatever I feel about the game, I don't really hesitate. And I go up to him and tell him, you know, I feel the game is going this way. Maybe we can try certain things. So he's quite approachable as well. I give a lot of credit to him. Like he appreciates a lot of inputs and he always tells us, you know, any input you feel, whatever you feel on the ground, even if you're a youngster, it'll be nice if you can communicate and tell us what's going wrong in the game or what we can do better. So I really feel calm and happy to be talking to him and sharing. He shares a lot of knowledge as well about the game and obviously he scored a lot of runs for India. So his experiences are quite valuable and he shares a lot with the youngsters.
But yeah, I'm really intrigued and to know that who was the guy sledging you from New Zealand, because we haven't really come across stories of, you know, a sledge fest happening in New Zealand. They are like the nicest guys around.
Yeah, all the bowlers, I would say. I mean, barring one or two, but they really come up to you, look in the eye, and they're quite clever in what they say and when they say as well. So, any opposition, for a matter of fact, even our bowlers, they can get quite feisty as well. But we try to show it more with the ball rather than talking to the batsman. But it's common nowadays in cricket, you know, wherever you go, whether it's England, Australia, wherever you go, even in South Africa, it's quite common the bowlers try to, you know, intimidate you with the ball and even with the way they talk.
You were part of Delhi Capitals classes and you got a couple of games. It's difficult to get games because there are so many other international players around. So what were the learning points? Because, you know, with Ricky Ponting as coach and you had all these other guys like Tanisha Rabada, Shreyas Iyer, he's also an India player, doing pretty well as a Delhi Capitals captain. So what were your learning points from this stint in the last season? Because that was after a gap of 3-4 years, I believe.
Honestly, I was quite disappointed. You know, last year, it would have been nice, you know, to get an opportunity at the top of that. Like you said, it is quite difficult with so many players gunning for the top order. You know, it's not easy to get a chance in the IPL at the top of the order. But things I've learned is the approach and the mindset of Ricky. Obviously, he's been a great captain for Australia. He's won a couple of World Cups for them. So the approach and the attitude which he showed, you know, it is all about winning kind of attitude. So that really drops off to all the teammates as well. You know, so I could really see the energy with which they were approaching a game. And obviously, it was tough for me because I was not part of that bubble, you could say, you know, in the playing 11. It gets tough, but I try to learn whatever. Like I always think like a captain, even if I'm not playing. So I was thinking of how what mindset he has and what I can take it in my game. And especially with Ricky, I think I learned a lot about captaincy and how he manages team.
Australia tour that's coming up, and we hear that the first test is going to be under the lights. I know that India played a test match under the lights at the Eden Gardens in Kolkata. I don't think you played that game, but then you had a fair idea of what pink ball cricket is all about, being a part of the squad, right? So tell us a little bit, how do you plan to prepare for pink ball cricket per se, and that too in Australian conditions where there's a lot of bounce?
I play one game in Dilip Trophy actually, pink ball.
Yes.
So I got and I got some runs as well in that game. So I have a little bit of experience of the pink ball will behave. But obviously, facing Australian bowlers is a different challenge altogether and in those conditions. But I feel, you know, pink ball, once you get in, it's a way, you know, you love to bat against it because it's quite similar to the white ball. It behaves quite similar to the white ball. Obviously, under light, it does a little bit with the new ball. And it's the same for both the sides as well. So we are really looking forward to playing against Australia under lights. You know, it's going to be exciting. But personally, I feel whatever it is, you know, you have to just watch the ball and play the ball. So I don't really try and get too deep into what ball I'm playing against. I try to focus on what I have to do. Like I said, in that situation, what I have to do. But maybe technically, if I have to make a few adjustments, I'll try to do before that.
Now I'm going to be, going to a very important person in your life. It was your captain first, but then this person is probably the most important person. That's your mother. And I have known Auntie's story of struggle, you know, when you lost your dad at a very early age, and how she actually, you know, saved money for your cricket and built that academy. And that pitch where you were practicing, where your mother as well as your sister used to feed you balls. So how special was that experience, you know, as a youngster to see, because we live in a society where we don't see these things much often.
You don't realize then, but afterwards you realize how special it was. You're quite young. And the only thing I knew at that point of time was, you know, to practice a lot of, hit a lot of balls, practice for hours, and the effort which they did, you realize it later, and I'm quite grateful to what they've done for me. You know, without that encouragement and the effort which they put, I don't think I can reach, I could have played for India, or I couldn't have done what I've done so far in my career. But a lot of credit should go to the family and the efforts which they have.
Right. And do you discuss your game with her, in the sense when you come back from a tour, does she tell you that, okay, I didn't like you played a rash shot there? Because she understands cricket really well, I know that for a fact. Yeah. Does she tell you all these things?
We talk more about the mindset, you know, what mindset I am in and whether I am in a good frame of mind, rather than talking about technically, I don't really talk to many people, maybe to Sri sir, or even batting coach of Indian team, Vikram sir, and I used to talk with Sanjay sir about technique, but I don't really change my technique much, so I'm not really open to discussions about that, but usually about mindset and what I'm thinking at that point of time, I try to share it with her.
When you are watching a game with her, like for example, I'm sure you're watching the IPL at home right now,
yeah.
I'm sure she will be around too. Do you have arguments with her?
We try to be neutral and try and enjoy the game now. Obviously, you feel that, you know, you want to be part of it, but somewhere down the line you feel now we don't really talk about, you know, cricket or we just watch and enjoy the game, you know, try to. Some of the games this year have been quite exciting, and you know, we watched all the games so far, and and it's great, you know, at this point of time to watch cricket itself is a blessing for us, and we try to enjoy.
How important do you think, you know, is time in T20 cricket? Because a bowler has only 4 overs to impress, and a batsman maybe he has a few balls to hit those runs that he has to. So how important is time in T20 cricket and IPL per se?
I would say for a bowler, like you said, it's only 4 overs, but it's also an opportunity for him. You know, in those 4 overs, he can, like, if he's a fast bowler, then he can go all out and, you know, try and pick wickets. Like they say now, best way of defense is attack. Like, you know, all the fast bowlers or even the spinners in IPL, you see now, they're trying to pick wickets rather than, you know, containing or going for less runs. They always try to pick wickets. Even for the batsman, I feel batsman time depends on where you bat. If you bat at the top of the order, then you have a bit more time than others who bat in the middle. But it depends on the situation for the batter. It always does. You know, a top order always has the advantage of taking a little bit more time rather than you know, the finisher who comes in at 17th or 18th over, he can't really have the luxury of taking a couple of balls more. He should get going from ball one. So it always depends on the where is batting on in the order.
One of your state mates, senior cricketer VBS Lakshman, he used to take showers before going out to bat. There are stories in Indian cricket where probably the person who got out is almost towards the pavilion, but then VBS sir is still in his shower. So what do you do before going out to bat? Every person has his different, like Sachin Tendulkar used to have sleepless nights. We all have read about it and seen in his interviews. What does Hanuma Vihari do when he's supposed to bat in a test match?
I tend to get quite nervous, you know, sitting there. Sitting there is the toughest part. Once you get in and take the guard, then you relax yourself. But sitting there waiting to bat is the toughest part in test cricket, I feel, you know. I always enjoy batting top of the order because of that. You know, you can get into bat. If you had a good day, you get 100 or you get some score. Then if you have a bad day, then you can put it behind. But batting at number 6, that tension is always there until you get into bat. So you have to wait for 4 wickets to fall actually to get into. But I always sit there and think about what they're trying to do, and it gets tough, you know. Mentally you get fatigued before you go into bat as well. So I try to relax myself sometimes, you know. I'll tell you a story where we were playing in West Indies recently, where I got my first 100. So it was the first test match. In the second innings, I decided that, you know, I'm actually batting at number 6. I can afford to take a nap. So I told my physio, you know, once a couple of wickets fall, then wake me up. So I actually slept for a couple of hours before before going into bat. And I felt quite relaxed. You know, I scored 90. I wouldn't say it was because of that, but you know, it helped me relax before going into bat.
No, but then there's also a lot of chatter around the dressing room also. Like if, for example, an opener got out and he's probably coming and sitting beside you and talking about the conditions and the wicket. Does that help you or does that make you more nervous? Because, for example, I remember Rohit said in his interviews that he likes to go to the ground a little early to get a feel of the ground, you know, to feel where the wind is blowing, to get into that zone. So does that help when you are, like, for example, for a number 6 batter in test match to sit there and see your openers coming back and the middle order guy coming back and Virat bats before you? So what is the conversation? What do they tell you when they come back? Do they talk about the wicket? Do you ask them questions?
Yeah, I do ask questions. You know, you have to understand the conditions. You know, batter was batter in the middle. They actually know what it's behaving like. You know, it keeps changing in test cricket. I wouldn't say it will stay the same in every session, but you actually get an idea of how you can plan an innings and what shots you can play and what shots you can avoid in that wicket. So I try to pick whatever information they're trying to give. And obviously, if some information puts you under pressure, I try to, you know, ignore it and keep myself focused again. But it depends, you know. Where we're playing. If you're playing in India, you don't have to know much. You already know how the conditions will behave. But if you're batting in tough conditions, then we have to know each and every tip what they can give as a top order batsman and try to adjust in your game.
I know the mind works very differently T20 because it's a different format, a faster format. So what do you do before a T20 innings?
I try to be flexible, you know, in my mindset. I can't. Like test cricket, you can't really have fixed mindset of how you're going to approach a T20 inning. Obviously, you go with the flow sometimes in T20 cricket. When you get a good start, you try to capitalize that momentum and get those runs quickly. Some days you don't really get off to a good start. You struggle. Maybe you'll be 10 balls 8 or 10 balls 7. Then you have to catch up really quickly in T20 cricket. So I try to be flexible and I'll see, you know, what situation I'm going into bat, and then once I'm in the middle, I try to have a plan of whom to attack. Like in opposition, you can choose a bowler where you feel comfortable to attack. So those kind of things I try to keep in mind before going into bat. And once I go into bat, it's just about the flow and the momentum over there.
People from Hyderabad are really crazy about movies and food and everything. So tell us a little bit. Do you watch enough? I mean, have you been spending enough time on Netflix?
Yeah, I've been watching a lot of TV series actually. Movies have not come up much in the quarantine. Otherwise, yeah. I would watch a lot of movies. I would love to watch a lot of Telugu movies as well. You know, I watch a lot of Bollywood, but nowadays I'm watching a lot of TV series which are going on, and I've been catching up to a lot of TV series which I've not watched in the past. So okay. that is getting me going in the quarantine period.
Which series have you been watching? Tell us.
I was watching Friends. A lot of people have told me that that there was one series you can't miss, and I watched all the 8 seasons, and I enjoyed it. You know, it was quite fun. I love Game of Thrones, so that is my favorite, all time favorite. So okay. I watched it again.
But then did you like the Game of Thrones ending? Because fans are always divided on social media when talking about Game of Thrones.
I didn't enjoy it as much. I expected a lot more. You know, Game of Thrones set a very high standard, and to that standard, I don't think it reached, the ending didn't reach to that kind of standard. But you can't, with one season, you can't really write off all the other seven seasons, you can say. But I really enjoy watching all the TV series, the latest ones as well, you know, Money Heist and all the series I really enjoy.
Which Telugu film did you last watch? And your favorite actors, anybody you really like?
So, Ala Vaikunthapuram was the last movie which I watched. It was of Allu Arjun. I liked the movie. It was quite fun.
My last question to you, Hanuma, that is, if you weren't a cricketer, what would you have been?
As a kid, I was very good at studies, so maybe I would have gone in that path, and I would have decided what I wanted to be, you know, once I finish my engineering or something. But I'm not sure. Otherwise, you know, since I was young, the only thing I knew was, you know, playing cricket. So I've never really thought about an alternative thing. But like I said, maybe I was a good student, so maybe I would have gone in that path.
Thank you, Hanuma, for your time, and I'm sure that good things are stored for the future. I've been keeping my time with Tissot Sea Star. I hope you have received your watch.
Yeah, it looks beautiful, and the latest edition, like they said, it's quite good. You know, I'm enjoying it.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your time. All the best for the Australia tour.
Thank you.